guys, and welcome to another Simply Dark episode. Today we are going to take a little break from the alien world and we are going to be covering a story of reincarnation. I personally love to read about this kind of stories. It always makes my mind wander, and the one I bring you today is pretty incredible. Many religions out there believe in reincarnation after we die, and it is widely accepted that after starting a new life, we do not remember our previous one. But what researchers found is that sometimes children do. Reincarnation memories happen almost 100% of the time in children aged between 3 and 5 years old. And very often these children have some kind of birthmark that either resembles the wound that the person died from, or it is exactly on the spot that the person who died had been attacked, if that was the case. Today's incredible story is about a 3-year-old boy from Golan Heights near Syria who was born with a very peculiar birthmark on his forehead. His name, however, was never made public as the family wanted to protect him and his privacy, but his story spread and shocked the world. Not only did he remember his past life, but also claimed he had been murdered, and he knew where his body and the murder weapon could be found. And he also went on saying that he knew the identity of the man who killed him. Dr. Ellie Lask, or Ellie Lash, I'm not even sure how to pronounce it. I will leave the name here so you guys know, but I will pronounce it Lask because I think, I don't know, it sounds better to me. He was a physician in Israel at the time and had a huge interest on reincarnation and help the family investigate the case. To check out the boy's claim, Dr. Lask and his family took him to 2 cities before entering a 3rd one that the boy recognized. When inside the village, the boy was able to recall his original first and last name and the first and last name of his murderer. An individual of that town overheard what the boy was talking about and said that the name that the boy mentioned, his past self, had gone missing 4 years ago and that no one have heard of him ever since. As they continued to check out the village, the boy was able to find his old home, and it was while they were walking around that the boy recognized someone passing by. He called the man by his name, even though he had never met him, and confronted him by saying, "I used to be your neighbor. We had a fight and you killed me with an axe." And it is reported that at this time, the man turned white. Like, he had no expression on his face, he just turned completely paper white. And the boy continued with, "I even know where you buried my body." Like, full chills right now. Can you imagine, guys, thinking that you got away with a murder and then years later a boy comes to you and say, "Oh, by the way, I know what you did, I know you killed me, and I'm gonna prove it." Like, how insane is that? The boy then led everyone away, including the murderer, to a backyard. And when they got there, he pointed out that that place was where his past life body was buried in conjunction with the murder weapon. And the town people that curiously gather around listening to the boy's story immediately started excavating the place, and not long after that they found indeed a skeleton. And what was particularly interesting and stunned everyone is that the mark on the skeleton's skull where the axe hit the victim corresponded exactly to the boy's birthmark. with all this evidence, everyone began to accusing the neighbor of murder, and he ended up confessing that in fact he had a huge argument with his neighbor and ended up killing him and burying him in that yard 4 years prior. Now, the only known witness to this incident was Dr. Ellie Lask, who very sadly died in 2009. All information provided here was based on her reports, and it is pretty much all we know about this case. This is a very strange tale indeed, and although it is so famous, there isn't a lot of information about it out there. So we can't actually tell for sure if this happened or not, as there is no concrete proof to verify any of it. Nevertheless, I thought this story was remarkably interesting, and I thought it was a good idea to cover it here, as reincarnation has been in our lives, cultures, for centuries. Now, what do you guys think? Do you believe in this story? Do you think this can actually be truth, or do you think this is someone that Dr. Ellie's made up? As usual, please let me know in the comments below all your thoughts about today's episode. I love to read your comments and reply to them. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If yes, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and join the family if you haven't already. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next episode.